At 14, she picked up a gun for the first time. At 16, she had become the undisputed Indian number one in the 10-meter air pistol event, broken multiple national records, beaten multiple Olympic medalists, won a Commonwealth Games gold, and also become the youngest Indian to win golds at the Shooting World Cup. Did I mention she's also already qualified for the Tokyo Olympics?
I don't have any idols. I just follow my heart.
From 2016 to 2020, Manu Bhaker's meteoric rise has been the stuff of dreams.
Streaks hi ho gayi ki medals pe medals aur medals pe medals.
But what's the last 4 years been like for her? There have been major highs but also big lows. I caught up with the fiercely confident, quietly shy 17-year-old as she prepares for her Olympic debut this summer. It's Manu Bhaker's success timeline on this week's Spotlight. Let's start at the beginning. All of 14, a young Manu had already excelled in a handful of sports. She was a state-level boxer, a three-time national champion in martial arts, and a state-level kabaddi player. But there was something different about shooting that drew her to the sport.
Shooting ka isliye I chose kyunki it was a very transparent sport. कि बहुत ज़्यादा पारदर्शिता थी उस स्पोर्ट में और लाइक बिल्कुल जैसा आप जितनी आप हार्ड वर्क करते हो उतना आप अचीव कर लेते हो जैसे कबड्डी और खो खो इफ़ यू सी कि वो टीम स्पोर्ट है अगर आपकी टीम अच्छा परफॉर्म नहीं करती है तो यू वॉन्ट बी एबल टू विन इट मैं शूटिंग में बहुत जल्दी से एक्सेल कर गई It took me like 2 months to win a medal in any open tournament.
And yes, just 17 months after picking a gun up for the first time, in August of 2017, Manu rubbed shoulders with Hina Sidhu, the Indian star in her event, while Hina, 27, was still the star in the senior category. Winning the gold, Manu, just 15 at the time, bagged the gold in the junior category with a better score than Hina's in the senior category. And then followed the big one. A 15-year-old Manu had tasted success, but what she pulled off at the 2017 National Championships may indeed be a record for the ages. The quiet girl from Haryana won a total of 15 medals, including 9 golds, and broke multiple national records. And also, she beat the former world number one in her category, Hina Sidhu, for the first time.
एक streak सी हो गई कि medals पे medals और medals पे medals. काफ़ी अच्छा मैंने परफॉर्म किया था मैंने भी एक्सपेक्ट नहीं किया था दैट आई विल बी परफॉर्मिंग सो गुड मैंने बस अपनी तरफ से बेस्ट किया वो रिकॉर्ड्स वगैरह टूटे दैट आई डिडंट न्यू सो नेशनल्स डेफिनेटली सबसे बड़ा जो मतलब लाइक उसके बाद ही लोग मुझे जानने लगे थे नेशनल्स के बाद
इफ मनु ग्रैब्ड हेडलाइंस इन इंडिया आफ्टर द नेशनल्स शी वन ओवर हर ओपोनेंट्स एज वेल विद सॉलिड गोल्ड मेडल विनिंग परफॉर्मेंस एट द खेलो इंडिया स्कूल गेम्स टू किक स्टार्ट हर 2018 सीजन And then came the biggest of all achievements. The 2018 Shooting World Cup in Mexico announced Manu on the world stage. Making her debut at 16, she beat a power-packed field, which included former champion Alejandra Zavala, as well as multiple Olympic medalists to win her first World Cup gold. In the final, it came down to Manu and Zavala, a stalwart, who had in fact been shooting competitively since 4 years before Manu was even born.
I was hoping for a medal definitely because us time tak I'd never lost any sport. In any sport, I hadn't lost any match. So us time pe I was like very confident ki I'd definitely win it. But while going to the finals, when I saw that the list of the, the qualification board, top 8 shooters, Olympic medals, and they had World Cup medals, they were world number 1, world number 2, etc. I was on the 5th or 6th position. Then I realized that this is not the like very easy stuff. I was very nervous about that. Then I was like, I will try my best, whatever it comes, I'll accept it. Gradually, I won it, so then I felt so happy.
While speaking to Manu during this interview, I sort of also realized that what worked for her could be the bubble this youngster chooses to stay in. Shooting wasn't a sport she followed all her life, and her competitors now aren't legends who she'd watched growing up. So, as it turned out, it was easy standing next to them at the start line of a World Cup and beating these world beaters at just 16.
I never used to read about anyone. So, it was like all about me. So, whatever I did, when I was standing in the finals only, then only I realized that. So when they introduce, they tell them, everything about the person. Ki she is the Olympic gold medalist or the World Cup double medalist or world number one, etc. So that time I thought ki one day I'll beat her. So it was the same day, I already beated her.
So now at 16, just 2 years after picking up a gun for the first time, Manu Bhaker had become a national champion with a national record, a World Cup winner having beaten multiple Olympic medalists. And next up was the 2018 Commonwealth Games, where she continued her winning run, setting a games record on her way to the gold.
I had no expectations at all. I was just playing my own sport. I was very serious about my performance, but not the medal. I was thinking about each and every shot, because har ek shot ki itni value hai. So wo gradually increase hote hote wo record bhi ban gaya aur I won the gold. So definitely it was the biggest ever, you know, a goal for India, and I won that.
But where there is success, there is controversy and setbacks, and Manu found herself in the middle of one when Hina Sidhu, the former world number one in the 10-meter air pistol event, alleged that the federation was changing the rules and favouring the favourites by letting Manu compete in 3 events at the Asian Games later that summer.
I don't think I had that in my mind, but Iqbar, I heard about that, but I didn't know how to react about that, so I just kept it aside. I tried to keep it aside. I don't know if it affected me or not, but I don't think it affected me. It was just my performance, I'd say.
Did it influence her performance, being pulled down by a shooter she would have looked up to? Can't really say, but Manu suffered her career's first major setback at the Asiad, failing to win a medal in each of the 3 events. In fact, in the 25-meter event, she shot a games record in the qualifying round but crumbled in the final to eventually finish 6th.
We have to hit the 10.2 ring, and I shot 10.1, 10.0s, and I was so confused, so, you know, bahut zyada परेशान हो गई थी मैं at that time. So I was very disappointed about that. But then soon I realized that it's just a competition in my way that will boost me up for the future things. So obviously, जीत और हार भी उतनी important है जितनी जीत है. तो I realized it soon and I recovered.
And what a recovery she made. Just 2 months later at the Youth Olympics, Manu held the lead in the 10-meter air pistol event straight from the qualifying rounds and right through the podium to become the first Indian woman to win a gold at the Youth Olympics.
In Youth Olympics, I was the best thing ever was that I was selected as the flag bearer of the country. That was the best moment ever. In Youth Olympics, I didn't know that nobody had won any medals. But then soon I realized, after winning the medal, soon I realized that I was the one, that was the only shooter that had won a gold or even a medal at Youth Olympics. So definitely that was a like once in a lifetime moment.
2019 though was a different kind of year for Manu. While on the individual front, she failed to finish on the podium at any of the World Cups all year round, she partnered with another teenage star, Saurabh Chaudhary, to complete a clean sweep of the mixed team goals in each of the World Cups. Last season, that's 4 golds. And while speaking to Manu about their partnership, I realized they sort of have a different kind of winning formula.
No, we don't depend on each other. We just play our individual match, how we want to play it, how we play it. So it's like another individual match for, I think, for me. I don't know about him. I stay in myself. I prefer music over everything. So I don't think about anyone else. It's just about my performance, how I perform. And about him, I don't know much about him. He's a totally different person. I don't know him well.
Now, on an individual front, Manu also booked a spot at the 2020 Tokyo Olympics with a 4th place finish at the Munich World Cup last May. There was, however, some heartbreak in the 25-meter event that she was quick to recover from.
In 25 meters, I was doing so good. I was on the first place throughout the finals. But then on the fourth elimination, my pistol couldn't fire. Because of that, I was eliminated. So it was heartbreaking because I had missed the medal also and the Olympic quota also. I could win it easily. But the pistol, you know, I don't know what to say about that. But very next day, I had air pistol match and I started it all like it was a beginning. I scored 582. It was my personal best. Medal wasn't like very important. Obviously, medal was important, but not more than Olympic quota, I'd say. And winning at that time in Munich World Cup, it was like mind-blowing. Because it was the toughest event.
Still only just 17 and with Olympic qualification pressure off her shoulders, Manu regained old momentum and finished off the 2019 season with two gold medals at the season-ending World Cup Finals, including one in her favourite event, the 10-metre air pistol. And now, as she prepares for the biggest test of her young career so far, one can only hope that this young star continues to believe in herself and marches on to newer glory this year round as well.